We saw this concept already. The concept of indirect material. An indirect material means originating material. Recall that to qualify for NAFTA, one of the concepts you have to meet is the concept of originating. And we learned that originating is a term of art. And it can be something which is also known as indirect material. And indirect material is really stuff that is helping you to make the product in a final stage of what it is that you will be importing into the United States. It is the collateral factors of production, if you will. And we have under the North American Free Trade Agreement, we have a laundry list of stuff that are qualifying as indirect materials. And customs examiners, because it's a laundry list, it is provided in Harmonized Tariff Schedule General Note 12, then customs will likely test you on that laundry list itself. So let's take a look of what that laundry list consists of. First of all, you have indirect equals originating. The second thing is the term indirect material means the production and testing inspection of the good, but not physically incorporated. Here is the buzzword, not physically incorporated. So if it is something which becomes a product, so if you use a chemical substance to create some kind of reaction to make a new chemical compound, that is incorporation. However, if you have things which you use in production, testing, and inspection, so if you use, for example, the chemical, using that, going back to that chemical reaction example, if you use the chemical kit to test the properties after you made that chemical reaction, then that is not physically incorporated, that is indirect, and that qualifies as testing and inspection. Maintenance production in the maintenance product which is made in using the maintenance of buildings or operation of the equipment. And here comes the laundry list that I was mentioning. Fuel and energy, tools, dyes and molds, spare parts, materials, lubricants, greases, compounds, gloves, glasses, footwear, clothing. So those are the stuff that, for example, the plant employees will wear to create something, right? Those are the materials that are used to facilitate the production of the product. Equipment, devices, and supplies used for testing. So recall that chemical testing kit. Or, and here is a kind of covered all clothes. Any other goods that are not incorporated in the good, but whose use in the production of a good can reasonably be demonstrated to be part of the production. So as long as it doesn't become part of the good, but it becomes part of the production, then you're good to go. Or things which you use in production, testing, and inspection. So if you use, for example, the chemical, using that, going back to that chemical reaction example, if you use the chemical kit to test the properties after you made that chemical reaction, then that is not physically incorporated, that is indirect. And that qualifies as testing and inspection. Maintenance production in the maintenance product which is made in using the maintenance of buildings or operation of the equipment. And here comes the laundry list that I was mentioning. Fuel and energy, tools, dyes and molds, spare parts, materials, lubricants, greases, compounds, gloves, glasses, footwear, clothing. So those are the stuff that, for example, the plant employees will wear to create something, right? Those are the materials that are used to facilitate the production of the product. Equipment, devices, and supplies used for testing. So recall that chemical testing kit. Or, and here is the kind of covered all clothes. Any other goods that are not incorporated in the good, but whose use in the production of a good can reasonably be demonstrated to be part of the production. So as soon as it doesn't become part of the good, but it becomes part of the production, then you're good to go. All right, so let's see how examiners test on this. Next, under the North American Free Trade Agreement, which of the following would not be considered indirect material? Again, so last question, it was an exception here. We are looking for the one that's not. Indirect material in the manufacture of ceramic dish. All right. So A suggests that purified wood or added to ceramic mix is or is not part of the considered to be indirect material. So purified water, once it added to the mix, it becomes part of the product. And it becomes, in other words, physically incorporated into the product. And because it becomes physically incorporated into the product, you have to exclude it because it is not. You can only have stuff that are not part of it, that can facilitate the production, but are not part of that production. Part of that product. I'm sorry. So purified water is a good example of something which breaks this rule, right? So it's incorporated into the good. So for this reason, A is not considered to be an indirect material. Production molds, electricity. So production molds, I think they're explicitly stated on the laundry list, right? So here you have molds. Then you have electricity used, right, to fire the product, and you have electricity fuel and as part of fuel and energy. Testing supplies and lubricants are also there. They explicitly provide. So lubricants is over here, right, and testing is over here. So I think we're pretty good on the rest because they're either explicitly provided or electricity, right, such as energy, can also be fairly allocatable. Purified water is on its face example, straight example of physical incorporation into the product. Of course, one might argue that this is not the case because the water somehow is not a component because the ceramic is then used to be to we have what product, the manufacturer of ceramic dish. So ceramic dish is getting fire glaze, so by the time the product is made, there is no water or almost no water is being left. However, that water is used there for the reason it has certain properties, and it may act as a bond, it may act as the softening agent, but it can be argued that it is not physically incorporated, but it is used to facilitate the production. However, if you have something which can be argued to something like which is grayish and which is not on all fours, you can the best way to take your strategy is follow the strategy of the best answer rule. We saw that those stuff are pretty much explicitly provided on the laundry list, and because we can include those stuff as originating because it's indirect, because it is part of laundry list, then we go check, 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 and this one, while it's a gray area, we can leave it as not the best answer. Therefore, not the best answer for fitting the indirect material, but since we are looking as not, then it is best answer under the circumstances. So this is another way to approach this type of question.